Hey guys, welcome back. So today's video is going to be on some non-beauty lifestyle favorites. I love doing these types of videos and you guys seem to love them too. So I'm gonna be sharing a bunch of products that I love and use and wear all the time. So there's some alcohol, there's some candles, there's some fashion items, there's some food, some fitness, just all types of categories of things that I am obsessed with recently. So I'm gonna first start off with the wines, because when I asked on Twitter what categories you guys wanted me to cover, so many of you said wines. So I will warn you that all of the wines that I'm going to mention are red, because after September, I don't really drink anything but red wine unless it's like Prosecco or champagne for mimosas or like a toast or something. So I'm gonna share a few of the ones that I love, and FYI, none of them are expensive because I drink too much wine to be spending like $20 a bottle, you know? So the first one is this one. It's called Paxis or something. I'm probably gonna say all of the names wrong, but this one is probably like the most mild flavored. It doesn't have like a super pungent flavor. It's not super dry. So if you're new to red wines, check this one out, because it's affordable and it's not gonna be like too strong or like too bold of a flavor. And obviously the packaging is what drew me in, but it also says that it's like one of these like best top rated ones. So I love the bulldog on here, and it's really good, it's cheap, and it's a good like beginner red, I would say. Then another one that we buy a lot is this one from Bogle Vineyards. It's a Merlot. I love Merlot. That's like my go-to when I go to a restaurant. I just ask for whatever Merlot they have. So this one's really good. It has a good flavor, not too expensive, and yeah, I mean the bottle is nothing special, but that's okay. It's good. So then another one, I'm pretty sure I talked about this last year, but it's just one of my favorites and I always recommend it to people because it's super good. So this is the 19 Crimes, the Banished one. This one is definitely my favorite one they have. It is a red blend, which basically means it's just a blend of reds. And a lot of you guys ask me, how do you know if like a wine is good? And to me, the easiest way to tell is if when you taste it and you think that it tastes good, that is how you know that it's good. I don't know. I don't know what makes a wine good. If you think it tastes good, then it tastes good. You don't need an expert to tell you if it's good or not. Like if you like the taste of it, then it's a good wine. I don't know what to tell you. So this one's from Australia, and there's like a cool app that you can download that like makes the guys on these bottles like come to life. It's pretty cool. So love that one. And then another one I recently got, I am obsessed with this. I still have like half left, thank goodness. This one is so good. So this one is the Ménage à Trois, and that is French. And if you don't know what it means, then Google Translator will help you out, because it's a little bit scandalous. But anyways, this is the Decadence Cabernet Sauvignon. It's from California and it's super good. It's definitely decadent. It just tastes good in your mouth. I don't know. It just feels like decadent and soft and flavorful. I don't know. It's really, really good. And it's not that much money. It's like $12, $13. And the description says luxurious, rich, and seductive, which who doesn't want to be those things? I mean, that's what I want. So that is it for wine. Those are the ones that I wanted to mention that I really love and wanted to suggest. All right, so next I guess we could talk about some food. There's not really a lot of food, but these I really wanted to suggest because I tried these out and I don't even know why. Well, I do know why, because I love chicken nuggets, but I saw these at the grocery store one day and the packaging just drew me in because they're called Super Duper Chicken Nuggets. So when I saw that, I was like, I am like a chicken nugget connoisseur, so let me be the judge. So here's the nutrition facts, and the nutrition looks pretty good. There's 12 grams of protein, only 13 grams of carbs, 4 grams of fat for 5 nuggets. So I thought that was pretty good. So there's also says there's less sodium, less fat, whole grain, pureed cauliflower, pureed onions. And if they're good enough for a kid with a developing brain, then they're definitely good enough for me. So next up are some chocolate vitamins, and I forget where I got these. I wanna say either Target or just like a grocery store, but they are the My Bite Beauty Inside and Out chocolate vitamins. So these honestly are like my after dinner treat, because I have such a sweet tooth after I eat, like I just want something chocolatey. So these, I feel like, make me feel better about the fact that I'm having chocolate, because they are vitamins. They have vitamin E, they have vitamin C, biotin, and I don't know, they're supposed to be good for your hair, skin, and nails, but in chocolate form. I'm not gonna have one right now, but I'll just show you what they look like. They're like this, and they kind of remind me of like a Snickers bar, but like in a little mini bite. So they're pretty good. They're made with dark chocolate and they're really good. There's caramel, peanuts, and a whipped center. I like these way better than the gummy vitamins because I'm more of a chocolate person rather than like a candy person. So I would definitely recommend these. All right, so then next I guess we'll move on to some like household products. So this is a laundry detergent. And let me just start off by saying that this is like the bougiest laundry detergent I have ever come across. So this is from the brand The Laundress. And it is in collaboration with the fragrance brand Le Labo. And so this is their like cult favorite scent, Santal 33, which I've talked about their candle before, I believe. And oh my God, it's just such a luxurious smell. If you've never smelled Santal 33, then it's really hard to describe. It's kind of like a smoky, just like really like rich, expensive, bougie smell. Like it smells super good. And so I actually found this on Amazon, and what I will do is I will just wash like towels, bed sheets, stuff like that in this. I mean, obviously you can use it for your clothes also, but since it's such a small bottle, I normally just use fragrance free, like the Arm & Hammer like clear detergent. It has like no added anything. So I will mostly use that, and then I will mix this in just to make it last a little bit longer. And oh my God, it smells so freaking good. Definitely bougie, but I think this would be like a really good gift, especially if you know someone who like loves this smell. They would really, really love this. So I wanted to mention this. I don't use it for everything, but it is 3 times concentrated, so it is very strong, and that's why I mix it, and it helps to last longer. So the next up is a hand soap, and this is from the Meyers Clean Day brand, which I love for cleaning supplies. So this is their limited edition scent called Orange Clove. And this one is so freaking good. It's a nice like break from your typical like evergreen or like pumpkin spice smell. It obviously smells like orange and clove, which is like, I don't know, I feel like it's like the perfect like holiday smell. And I don't know, it just smells super good. It doesn't dry out your hands, and it's just really good. So if you guys have not tried the orange clove scent of this one, definitely check it out because it smells amazing. So then we have some candles, and I recently restocked on a bunch, but I wanted to mention a few that I think smell absolutely amazing, and they're all from Bath & Body Works, and they are from the White Barn line. So this is the first one. This is the one, it's called Berry Spritzer, and it comes in like this matte, like dark purple packaging. It's gorgeous, and the smell of this one, this smells just like the Love Spell perfume from Victoria's Secret. This smells exactly like it. Like it smells just so good and fruity. And it's not like necessarily like a fall or winter smell, but I feel like it just smells amazing. And if you ever liked that smell from Victoria's Secret, it just reminds me of like middle school, then you would definitely love this. So I would definitely recommend this smell. Another one that I wanted to mention is this one. This is the gingerbread and caramel one. So the packaging is obviously super cute, and it smells just like it says. It smells like gingerbread and caramel, or caramel. I never know how to say it. It makes me feel weird. But yeah, this one smells like caramel, vanilla, and gingerbread all mixed into one. So definitely a really yummy holiday scent, but it doesn't smell like too sweet or like foodie. I don't know. I don't like scents that smell just like fresh baked cookies or hot chocolate. That's not my kind of thing. But this one, it smells like cinnamon and gingerbread and caramel and vanilla all mixed to one, but not too sickly sweet. So definitely recommend that one. And then the other one that I just got, this one, oh my God, for the cold weather months, this is going to be my new favorite. So this one is the Balsam and Firewood smell. So basically this smells like a smoky Christmas tree, which I don't know, that doesn't sound good, like a burning on fire Christmas tree. That probably doesn't sound good, but it smells really good, like a marshmallow mixed with a Christmas tree, like a burnt marshmallow mixed with a Christmas tree. That's a better description, but smells so good. So if you like the marshmallow fireside ones, you'll definitely like this one because it has like a hint of Christmas in there. So that's this one. Okay, so the next are some fashion essentials. So first are these earrings, and I absolutely love these. So I feel like they're glam and just like a nice break from like my traditional hoops, and I don't know, I just feel like they look kind of like 80s or 90s or something, and I just really like them and I wear them all the time. So I wanted to mention those, and they're really cheap. I think they're like $7 from Target. The next are these like newsboy or baker boy hats, and I have a bunch, but I will link all the other ones that I have. I just cannot find them right now, but they are these hats, and if you follow me on Instagram, obviously you see that I like wear hats like this quite a bit, but I feel like they're just nice for just bad hair days, or if you just don't want just your plain old regular hair, this is just like a nice little twist. So this is like a plaid one, and I think this is really cute for, you know, fall and winter. So I have this in green, I have it in black, I have it in brown. So I have a bunch, and I will link the other ones that I have in the description box. But this one is from Windsor, and I just really like the plaid print. And if you have not worn hats like that before, don't be afraid to wear them. I feel like they're super cute, and when you first start wearing them, you feel kind of like a tool, but then you get over it and then you love them. So try them. Next are two bags that I have been carrying. And so the first one is this Chanel, and this is the classic medium flap in the caviar leather. I'm obsessed with this bag. It is definitely a splurge, but I've always wanted a Chanel bag since I was like 13. Like, I drew a ginormous Chanel sign on like my baby pink walls in my room in high school, and I don't know, I just have always wanted anything Chanel. So I finally splurged and got this. I got it pre-owned and it looks amazing. So this is one bag that I'm totally obsessed with, and this is the medium size. I'm not sure if I said that, but I am obsessed. And then the other bag is this one. This is from Louis Vuitton. This is the Clapton PM. And this is like my everyday bag. I just love it. I love the black with the brown and with the gold hardware. I love that I can wear it crossbody or over the shoulder. I love that it has like this pocket in the back for just putting my phone in, so I don't have to like open it every time I want to take my phone out. It's just like my favorite bag that I have currently. It also has feet at the bottom, so if you want to set it down, it's just like the perfect bag. So this is the Louis Vuitton Clapton PM. Then I have two pairs of boots that I wanted to show you guys that I wear most often. So first are these boots from Steve Madden. They have a pointy toe and they go above the knee. So they go over the knee. They make your legs look so long and lean, and there are no ties. I don't like the ones with the ties in the back, because then I have freaking strings flapping and hitting me in the back of the leg, and that's super annoying. So they don't like scrunch down or fall down at all. I don't know how they do it, but they just stay up perfectly and I love them. So here's what they look like, just like that, just, you know, your basic. And I love that the heel is not too high, so they're perfect for like more of like an everyday boot. And then the other ones that I wear most often are these ones from Express, and they are like this faux leather material, kind of like a western style booty with a pointed toe, and I just love these. They go with like everything. I love the black heel, and they're not suede, so you don't have to worry about like the snow or the rain like ruining them. So the next up are these faux leather leggings from the Spanx brand. These are my favorite. They are more expensive, more of like an investment, but they make your butt and your stomach look so flat, and then your butt look like tight and round and just good, and they're so incredibly comfortable. Like, you would think a faux leather legging is not going to be comfortable at all, but these just feel like you're wearing like any other like legging. They are just so comfy, and these are the pebble print, so they look like pebbled leather, like if you can see next to my Chanel. Like, it's like that pebbled kind of leather. So they have these in another style, which is like more smooth, which I might get those as well. But I just liked the look of these. Also, they don't make you feel like you're sweating or anything like that. I was a little bit worried that they would make me feel like hot and sweaty, but they don't. But they also don't make me feel cold like when I'm wearing them outside. So I don't know. They're like magic pants. They make your body look better than it is, and they're comfy. And yeah. And then one other thing I wanted to mention is this teddy bear jacket. And I mentioned this on Instagram, and so many of you guys ended up buying it. And I got this on Amazon. It is like $30 or something, and it's so incredibly soft. You just have to order it to just really know how soft it is. But it's so cozy, and I wear this all the time. Like, when I'm running out the door, this is one of my favorite things to just throw on because it's just so cute and it's cozy and it's soft and it has like a zipper, but you don't have to zipper it up. It's just so warm. And oh, there's something in my pocket. What's in there? Oh, some glasses. Nice. But anyways, this is the coat and I'm just literally obsessed with it. It's so soft. And obviously this teddy bear fabric is super trendy right now. Another thing I wanted to mention that I have been obsessed with are my Lightroom presets that I've been using for all my Instagram photos. I recently came out with my own presets after I was like using other people's and just tweaking them so much. So I have been using them on my feed and I feel like they're really great for fall and winter. So you just download them on your computer and then send to your phone, and then you can just use the Lightroom app on your phone to edit all of your pictures. That's what I do. I never really use a computer ever to edit my Instagram photos. So if you guys are interested in taking your Instagram feed to the next level, then definitely check those out. I'm obsessed with them, obviously, because I created them. But yeah, I will put the link to them in the description box. So then one other thing before I show you guys fitness stuff, and that is my phone case. I always get questions about my phone case. This is the iPhone 10, but the phone case on it is just a life proof. So I will link it below, but you guys always ask me. When I got the new iPhone, I got this new case and I got the black one. So it comes in other colors, but I just love it because I literally drop my phone every 4.5 seconds. So I can't not have a life-proof case. And I like this one because it's like clear, so it doesn't like take away from the look of the iPhone, which I feel like is so pretty in general. So, you know, it's good. I like it. And to wrap up this video, I'm going to take you guys downstairs to my workout layer and show you two fitness pieces that I use all the time and I love. Okay, so now I'm in my basement in my workout center. I am not really the best at working out. I'm slacking lately, but I still wanted to mention some things. Also, I totally forgot that I wanted to show you guys my slippers that I'm obsessed with. They are from Target and they're these fuzzy leopard slippers and they are so freaking soft. So I wanted to mention those really quick. Then I wanted to show you guys this glute band, which is from my girl Suzie KB Fitness. And this is like the glute band that she came out with. I love that it's pink and it has like her little logo on it. But basically, you just intensify all of your moves with this thing on here. So, you know, just good stuff. Real good stuff. You know, very good. And it's pink, so who doesn't love pink? Next, we have this machine. It's called the Booty Sprout, which I need. I need to sprout my booty. So I wanted to show you guys this because I showed it on Instagram really quickly on my story one time. So I wanted to show you guys. But basically, it's like a hip thruster, but without having to use like a barbell, it has a resistance band. So it comes with three resistance bands, which I believe are like 45 pounds each. So you just put it through this little protective thing so it doesn't like hurt your stomach. So then you clip it in and then you put it across your lap, put your back here, then you just go like this. I know this is really attractive, but you know, you just thrust it, you know, you just thrust. I don't know. Please don't look at me, don't make eye contact with this move, you guys. But obviously you can make it more challenging with more bands, but I feel like it's like a really good thing to have. It gives you like the best form and you don't have to worry about like putting a giant barbell on your pubic bone area because that is super painful. So I just wanted to show you guys really quick, this is what it's called, and it has like this foam little back support and it folds up too. I'm not gonna take the hinge out, but it folds up too if you guys want to just like collapse it and hide it away. But I wanted to mention this because I think it's a really great little home workout piece and definitely could be a good Christmas gift. So that is gonna wrap up this video. I hope you guys enjoyed hearing about some of my non-beauty favorites. Basically a bunch of products that are not gonna make you look any prettier necessarily. The wine will make other people look prettier. This will make your butt look prettier, but overall, there's nothing that's really going to change your face or hair. So, anyways, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video.
Like a newborn child. This is also how I would hold my Academy Awards for Best Hallmark Christmas Movie cameo.